Coming up, we'll look at the latest updates to the Microsoft Quantum Development Kit. Microsoft's quantum mission is to develop and deploy a quantum computing system spanning both hardware and software, and to support a rich ecosystem of domain experts, developers, and researchers to solve today's most challenging problems using quantum computing. If you're new to quantum computing, you can learn about the core concepts by checking out our previous episodes at the link shown. To enable quantum algorithm development and grow a quantum community, we recently introduced the Microsoft Quantum Development Kit, which includes the Q-Sharp quantum programming language, samples and tutorials to get started, and target machines to enable simulation of your quantum programs, hardware execution, and resource estimation. I want to thank you, as part of our growing community, for your overwhelming support. The community engagement has been impressive, and today we are excited to partner with you as we open source the Quantum Development Kit on GitHub. Through open source, we hope to empower you to explore quantum computing and contribute to solving some of our world's most important challenges, such as clean energy solutions and resource-efficient food production. In the field of medicine, for example, we have a partnership with Case Western Reserve University to advance MRI scanning for higher accuracy so that we can detect disease faster. Today, I'll highlight some of our latest updates to the Quantum Development Kit that make it easier for you to jump into quantum programming, whether it be to contribute to quantum algorithms and applications, or to compilers and tools for mapping Q-Sharp programs to quantum hardware. Let's start in the Microsoft Quantum Development Kit samples repository on GitHub. You can get to it by doing a quick search for Microsoft Quantum, or you can use the link shown, aka.ms/quantum-samples. From here, we are going to run the samples in Binder. Once you launch Binder, it will spin up a container with the Quantum Development Kit preloaded, as well as a Jupyter notebook. You don't have to install anything locally, allowing you to get started quickly. And you'll be able to launch in Azure Notebook soon. We've recently added new samples for numerics and chemistry, as seen here. Let's step into the samples directory, which contains many examples of quantum programming and algorithms. One sample I'd like to highlight is Intro to IQ Sharp, which is an introduction to quantum computing and Q Sharp using Jupyter notebooks. The notebook contains detailed text describing the operations in the cells, so it's easy to follow along as you execute the code. Plus, you get instant feedback within the notebook if you make a programming mistake. Now, as I scroll in the notebook, you'll see that I can call into different libraries of the Quantum Development Kit. For example, here, to do a pi conversion or look up a math function. Jumping to cell 5, we can see an example of working with qubits in the code. We need to be able to prepare a qubit in a quantum state or evolve and change its quantum state. Here, the Q-Sharp code randomly prepares a qubit into one of two states, plus or minus. And we can call this operation within another operation. So I can do the things that I'm used to doing in Q-Sharp directly within the notebook. And now, if you scroll down in the notebook, we can simulate that operation using the simulator target machine, and you can view the output right here in the notebook. We've also gone beyond instant feedback with self-paced learning exercises called Quantum Katas. Katas help you deepen your understanding of quantum computing and develop your expertise in Q-Sharp programming. We have a number of Katas available as Jupyter notebooks. And to save time, I've already launched a new repository in Binder. You can get to it via aka.ms/online-quantum-katas. I'll choose the basic quantum computing gates kata. This kata introduces fundamental concepts of quantum computing, such as operations to entangle qubits and change their state. Now, each kata task asks you to fill in the blank with Q-Sharp code to complete the task. You can verify your answer by executing the cells. For example, here, if I type an incorrect answer, then the kata, once executed, helps me understand where I went wrong. As you progress through the katas, the tasks introduce you to more advanced quantum computing and programming concepts. To help you complete the tasks, we also have detailed documentation. And when you're really stuck, you can refer to the task's solution, found in the reference implementation file. If you like an enterprise-grade development environment, the Quantum Development Kit is also integrated with Visual Studio. In Visual Studio 2019, for example, you can get inline code guidance and feedback directly in the Text Explorer. Here I've opened the super dense coding kata. This kata introduces the concept of quantum entanglement, and I encourage you to go back into the kata and step through it in detail. When I run this kata, the unit tests on the left indicate where I've made a mistake. Here you can see one has failed, indicated by the red X. I can click on the test and then get a detailed error message. Now, if I replace this instruction with another instruction, you'll notice it becomes underlined with a red squiggle. And as I hover over it, I see a light bulb. The Q-sharp compiler is providing me with a useful suggestion on how to fix the error. And by hovering, I can see that in this case, we haven't yet opened the correct namespace, and it's prompting me to insert the correct open directive. And now, when I run the test again, my unit test should pass. In this environment, I also get detailed feedback on the program variables, operations, and functions. For example, if I click on a variable name in the code, it will highlight where the variable is used. You can also right-click on the variable to go to where a variable is defined. And if I want to rename a variable, I can even replace all occurrences of it by simply right-clicking on the instance and selecting Rename. Now let's switch gears to an important application area for quantum computing, chemistry. We have several new chemistry packages developed with our community partners, including a new release with 1-qubit for intermediate-scale quantum solutions. Today, I'll highlight our work with Pacific Northwest National Laboratories. It brings together advanced quantum algorithms for chemistry in Q-sharp and the open-source HPC chemistry tool NWChem. And together, it enables simulation of molecular interactions and exploration of real-world applications for chemistry with the Quantum Development Kit. For this demo, I'm using Visual Studio Code, an open-source cross-platform development environment from Microsoft. We'll calculate the resources required to find the energy of a particular state of molecular hydrogen. I'll use the resource estimator for the target machine. It enables you to determine the number of qubits and operations required to execute your quantum application on quantum hardware. We've loaded a description of a chemistry problem, written in a format we call Broombridge. In Q-sharp, we've expressed our quantum algorithm. And we can now execute against the resource estimator target machine and obtain counts of the numbers of operations required to execute this example. By connecting to tools such as PowerShell and Python, we can visualize analytics. Here we've plotted the results of the resource estimation. On the y-axis, you see the names of each chemical configuration, and on the x-axis, you see the numbers of operations required for different optimizations applied to the quantum algorithm. From this information, we can quickly learn which optimizations work best. Thanks for watching this quick tour of the latest highlights of the Quantum Development Kit. Whether you're a professional developer, quantum expert, new student, or avid researcher in this space, your contributions to this revolutionary field of quantum computing will be pivotal in advancing our quantum understanding. You may be programming the next quantum killer application right now. To learn more or share your feedback, visit docs.microsoft.com/quantum. And don't forget to watch the rest of our quantum computing series on Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching, and start quantum programming today.